So, how are you? I'm back in the Netherlands, back in the office. I just came back from Dubai yesterday. I had some wonderful meetings and unfortunately I cannot tell you anything yet about these things. But if everything goes the way I hope it will go, then we're going to do some really amazing things. So stay tuned about that. So while I was away, my guys continued working on the Port 150 Raptor for Trust Gaming. And to go a little bit more into the details, tomorrow we're going to decide exactly how the plan is going to be in terms of the audio system. So which components we are going to use and the way we're going to install everything. But first of all, very important is to do all the soundproofing and to run all the cables into the car, into all four doors. So the back shelf of the car was already soundproofed. I don't know how it gets on the microphone, but normally it sounds like this. And now it sounds like this. So it's very solid, it's very thick. And that's only the outside shelf. So of course we're going through the inside shelf as well and the door panel itself as well. So it will be very massive. It's very important for this car to sound absolutely crazy loud. Crazy loud, so beyond everything. So there will be a lot of amplifier power and we're going to use the Hertz SPL line speakers. But we're not sure exactly which of the components we're going to install. On the inside, this will be covered with the thick dampening material as well. And over here, let me show you on the other side. That's a nice way of showing before and after, right? So, on this side, there's the hole for the speaker and there's another big hole. I don't know exactly what the purpose of it is. Maybe to access the lock if you need to change it or whatsoever. And also if you have to remove the window, you also have to open this up. And normally this is just a piece of plastic which is glued onto here. But since we have to build up a high pressure level, we need the whole door to be an enclosure, a solid enclosure. So what we came up with is to make 1 centimeter thick ABS plate, which is exactly in the curve and shaped in the way that it fits perfectly. We glue that with a special glue, which they normally use to glue the front window into the car. Glue it into place, so it will be very solid. And if maybe in the future the window needs to be changed, it is possible to cut the glue loose to remove the panel and to access the bolt. It will not be a 10-minute job as it is when the car is not touched, but anyway, it is possible. And then we cover it up with the soundproofing materials as well. So in that case, we have a huge enclosure for probably an 8-inch mid-bass speaker, and there will be horn-loaded tweeters in there. So this will be massive. So let's go back to the other door. So here you can see it. So it's glued and we use some duct tape just to keep it in place. So don't worry, this is not the final fitting. when the glue is dry tomorrow morning, then we will take it all out and we cover it with the soundproofing. That is what we are doing right now. In half an hour I have a meeting with a company who builds custom gaming PCs. We have all the specs which are needed by Trust to play their games and everything. And we have to have custom PCs built into 19-inch rack casings because it's the only way to fit it properly in the trunk. If you use just the normal PC casings, I don't see a proper way to mount them, and if it's 19-inch, then it's more serviceable as well. So that's what we're going to do. This will be a really high-spec PC, and there's not one, not two, but there will be four in there. And we're thinking maybe about building in a fifth, so if something happens when they are on a tour or whatsoever, they can easily swap that PC out just by reattaching the cables. So there's always one standby if something is needed. So that's what we're going to do. Then this week we also have to make the final plan which gaming monitors we are going to use. And when we have that and we have everything into here by next week, then we can really start building the construction in the back, which will slide out to access the gaming mode. And also we are thinking about, because Kevin is going to build a custom roof rack, we are thinking about putting a DJ booth on top. That will be very nice. So we have to have an outdoor waterproof flight case where the DJ gear will be in, and we're going to build something inside, we're not sure what yet, which you can stand on. So you will, let me show you, that's more easy. Come, we go back to the other side again. So somebody can go up here, stand over here, can you see the picture, and then play all the tunes, so he can oversee everything, he or she, and play some nice tunes and really make sure there will be a huge party. So I'm quite excited, I hope you are as well, and really stay tuned, and we try to show in our vlog as much as possible about this project. How are you?
Good to see you, buddy.
Everything okay?
Yeah, yeah.
Good. Okay. Welcome. I told you about this car, which we are doing right now for a company called Trust Gaming. Okay. They built all the gaming equipment, like the mice and the keyboards and everything. And I showed you the pictures. Yeah. How we want to build everything. So this car is going to be very crazy, very nice. And of course it needs a massive sound system, as massive as possible, with the limitation of space as we always have.
Nice, yeah.
So that's why I invited you to see whatever we can do in terms of which items we're going to use exactly. To create the best end result. As you already knew that this is not a car which needs to have a perfect sound stage inside of the car, like we normally do.
Yeah.
This has to play loud and impressive from the outside. So if they are on a gaming convention or something, exhibition, then it has to be loud outside the car. So standing next to the car has to be impressive. And also in the back. So okay. In the back, this is the place where we're going to construct the frame, which will slide out with the computer screens and everything, so people can play their games here. And we have some space here as well to put some speakers in or under this frame, and the part which will stay in the car, like the 19-inch rack with the gaming PCs and the power supplies and everything, that will stay there. We might have some space available to install amplifiers and subwoofers in there as well.
Okay.
So the idea I had is to put subwoofers over there and to put the speakers in the frame which slides out, because I don't think it will make any sense to keep some speakers inside, because it will be all closed up.
The stop will remain.
Yes. On the top. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Do you need to cut a hole for the DJ booth?
No, this is actually something nice. Let me show you. I already showed our viewers yesterday how we're going to do that. Because Kevin is going to build a custom roof rack for this car. And then the DJ will be playing over here, on top of the roof.
Ah, great.
Is this nice or what?
Yeah, great. Nice.
Hey.
It's crazy.
I think you know me by now, right?
Yeah.
Eh? After all these years.
It has to be like this.
We get to do some crazy things, and
this is nice, yeah.
Yeah.
Really nice. Okay.
So that's the way we have to do it. So
let's get started. Huh?
Yeah. I was thinking using the Hertz SPL speakers.
Monster line.
Yeah, for the most output. With the horn loaded tweeters and all these things.
For maximum SPL.
Yeah, this is not something we normally do, because we cannot install the big speakers in the Ferraris and Lamborghinis and whatsoever, but in this car we are able to do something. So be as creative as possible.
You can go all the way, eh?
As always, yes.
Okay, nice. Yeah, that's gaaf.
Dat is toch cool?
Ja. Moeten we doen. Dat is echt nice.
Alright.
Mooi voetstuk. Ik moet er neerzetten. Ja. En dan moet hier goed geluid in zitten. Om het te resoneren.
Ja, gewoon hard. Hard en goed. Zo, what I prefer to do is to use the original speaker locations and to put in there the most efficient speakers available. Yeah. We thought about constructing whole door panels and all these things, but in my opinion, I think it's better to install the speakers into the steel of the door instead of making a panel out of wood and fiberglass or whatsoever.
Yeah.
It both has their advantages and disadvantages.
Pros and cons, yeah.
But I think we have to focus on, you know, less equipment, but better quality, better mounted and whatsoever, instead of
more stiff and reliable.
Yes. So I think if you use the biggest speakers which will fit in there from that Hertz SPL line, I think that would be best. And we can make something nice into the door panels to install the tweeters. Like, for instance, this is the rear door panel, which goes to the left rear door.
Yep.
So to put the speaker behind it, maybe we can change the grill into something better, which will allow the sound to come through much more. But to remain the factory looks, and then we have to see whatever we can do to make the tweeters angled out of the car.
Yeah, most important that the doors remain resonant free.
Yeah, and there will be a lot of sound proofing.
It will be a challenge.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, especially because it's big doors and with an
big doors.
American car, it's different. So
yeah, okay, other challenge, huh?
Mm-hmm.
The back seat.
Mm-hmm.
Does it remain in this car?
It will remain in the car because
there's a lot of space, eh?
It is, but the thing is, this will be seats as well because we're going to install the biggest screens possible into the front seats. So this will be a playing position
console
as well.
Also, yeah.
So
okay,
there
nice.
Will be two PlayStations over here, so people can do the PlayStations, the PlayStation games inside of the car, and the PC game, PC games in the back.
Ah, okay.
So this has to still has to be there. I was thinking to make an underseat subwoofer for this car under the bench, under the couch. With as many subs as possible, depending on the internal volume of the enclosure, of course.
Okay.
We can install some amps behind the seat.
Let me walk around the car.
And then, also very important, that's how it is always. Hey, Mom.
Yeah.
Where are you?
Yeah.
Ah, okay. Yeah. Also very important, basically, it's two systems. So one separate system inside of the car and one system in the back of the car,
sure.
Which are able to be connected together, if you know what I mean. So normally in a normal situation, the stereo system inside plays from the radio from the car, so they can connect Bluetooth devices and whatsoever. And also when they're driving, you know, they still have the availability to play their music. Then there's a system in the back which will turn on if everything slides out. But there has to be the possibility that everything in the systems, both front and back, will play the sound either from one of the PC games, one of the PlayStations, from the head unit of the car, or from the DJ booth.
Everything has to work synchrone?
Yes. So either separately or all together. And also we have to make input connectors and output connectors. So let's say, for instance, if they are on an exhibition and they already have sound in the booth, that it's possible to connect it to the car, so the sound from the booth will play from the car. On the other side, it's also very important, let's say if they go to some party or whatsoever and they have the DJ playing from the roof, then it's possible to take the output from the DJ gear and to connect it to the PA system of the booth or whatsoever. So inputs and outputs and controllable and switchable. To make it more easy for you.
Yeah, thank you. We have a great challenge.
You're welcome. So I was thinking that maybe the amplifiers which we are using for the inside of the car, to mount them behind the seat, behind the rear seat.
You have their space, yeah.
Yes. And then the amplifiers which will be used for the back side of the car, to install them in the back. Yeah, and then we can consider maybe using car audio amps or home audio amps.
Depends on the power supply. That's the most key.
Yeah.
Yeah. In this project.
I know.
Power. Where do you get it from?
That has to be calculated yet, because when we receive all the PC gear and everything, because that will drain a lot of power.
Yeah.
Then we do the measurements how much power it actually consumes. Because the specs from the suppliers are not 100% fixed, you know, because it's a special configuration in PC. So it's better to get the PCs here, have everything up and running. Then we can measure the power, how much it drains in total.
The real power.
The real power. And then we can calculate how much batteries and converters and chargers we need.
Yeah, first know how much current the installation draws.
Yes.
And then make calculation what solution.
Yeah, I mean with all the car audio amps, we exactly know how much amps it will drain. Yeah. So that's quite easy to calculate, but with the PC gear and the big screen TVs and whatsoever, say it's like 3 amps or 2 amps, but I want to know for sure.
Yeah.
Because it will make a huge difference.
Yeah, and it has to be working 3 years in a row.
Yeah, and it has to be idiot proof and it has to work 24/7.
Great.
Yeah. So, what can we do? What were you thinking about? I have some samples of the speakers. Maybe we can take some speakers and see whatever fits.
First, we have to measure up the depth of each door panel. That's how big the magnet can maybe be for maximum. Mm-hmm. And then we choose the woofers and speakers.
You can change. One speaker of each. So we can check it with the actual speaker. So this is 6.5 inch. This, this might be possible to fit in the rear. This might be able to fit in the front. These are massive speakers, by the way. Oh. Look at these, can you imagine? Oh.
USPL, eh? High efficiency loudspeakers.
I think this will be loud. What do you think?
I don't think you can see it goes loud.
And this is actually the smallest one, eh? Listen. Oh my god.
A little bit different than the high sound quality.
Unbelievable. Can you see?
This is one size bigger.
And this next is the biggest one. Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
So, only chance we have, what does fit? What and where does it fit?
There are mid-ranges in the market, even smaller than this.
This is the easiest.
Boom!
6.5 inch. Look at the magnet then. The magnet will fit, but then you need a big ring, but it doesn't mean that it doesn't fit.
Yeah, but we have to check whether the window will go down.
Yeah,
and
the depth. So we need to drop down the window.
Mm-hmm.
But both have some challenges. This will surely will fit, but for high SPL, the bigger the better. The bigger the magnet, the louder the sound. And you have crystal clear sound, eh? Because a nice paper cone opens up the mid-range also very good in combination with the high efficiency tweeters.
I don't think this will go, to be honest.
Too much
Yeah, because we don't have that much space.
The basket is too big.
And then also the grill of the
door will not fit, huh?
No, it will be too small. So most of the sound will stay behind the door panel and will get sound very annoying. So yeah, I would say in this case for the rear door it would be better to use the 6.5 inch. This will give a much better performance. Yeah, we are going to build very solid rings.
Yep.
So let's stick on the 6.5 inch for the back, okay?
Okay. And the front doors same size?
I don't know, because maybe we might be able to install one size bigger.
Yes.
It must be 100%.
That's nice.
No doubt.
It's an 8 inch. Eh?
No doubt. 8 inch in the front, 6.5 inch in the back. Okay.
Great idea.
Okay. Perfect. So we just use that, and then we have to figure out where to put what tweeter, because I would like to use those just because they look cool.
You can do both. This for the lower mid range, high frequency, and this for the super high frequency.
Why don't you?
Is it the kleinste too? Smallest one?
That's the smallest. I think that's worth it.
One you need to do is the beaming of the tweeters. Where does it start and where does it end? And this is really important, the placement. You can't just take it out of each other because of the beam effect and comfort.
Can't we put this one here and put two of those there?
Yeah, just to go extreme, but then the efficiency of the tweeter is so much higher. It's almost 110 dB.
Mm-hmm.
And the mid-range is 96. So you need only 1 watt for this.
Yeah.
And you need hundreds of watts for the mid-bass.
Yeah,
so
true.
What I try to keep is the SPL of each component, or the combination, that the efficiency of the total system is fluent, consistent.
Now how much SPL are these?
108. So it's totally different ball game than a normal sound quality level.
So what should we do?
First we're gonna look where's the spaces, which spots can we use. A simple thing like this, a tweeter here, make sure that the total system will sound with head up, like we formerly do in kick panels.
Yep.
And also if you put it like this in for show and the doors are open, then the sound, the time delay and the phase is more coherent.
Yeah.
So this would be, could be a cool idea to put something in here. Mm-hmm. And the only thing is they don't need an ashtray. So that you need to put something before for it.
Yeah.
But this is for the total sound quality of the system, the best solution. And the other thing is, if this isn't in there, is to do it like this.
Mm-hmm. Like this. Yeah.
Yeah, better?
Yeah, yeah.
Size is... if you want to remain some cosmetics, the smaller the easier is. But the nice thing is that you have a panel of something like this, and that you aim it up, and then you have a more source point.
Mm-hmm.
If the rest, it's a small grill, other things won't fit. It would be cool here, but if it doesn't fit because of the depth.
Yeah, also, and then here it cannot be angled, and over here it can be angled.
Yeah, it's better.
Mm-hmm.
And the distance to the tweeter is
almost
nice.
Same.
No, but it's nice that this is more longer, and it can if it's active, I can delay it a little bit more, mm-hmm. so that the sound will go up either other way, but also you can beam it or aim it yeah. more.
All right, so
but the direction up is best way to go.
Okay, that's fixed.
There's no other option.
So what we are using then in this case. So this will be the SV200.
SV165.
This is the ST35. This is the SV165 and this will be the ST25. Am I right?
Yep.
Do it like that. All right. So
does it need a channel, Brian?
No.
I don't know if this is discussed.
Okay. No, we don't need it. There is one in there. We will take it out and that's it.
Yeah, but it, sometimes in the back, if you want to play games and you know. Don't use headphones, you have a
but
large
that's the
scene,
thing. If
then you can use a right speaker
yeah.
and you can do a double center speaker,
no, you know,
so you have two
what
times
the thing
stereo.
Is, no, we're not doing that, because okay. we really want to use their gear. So let's say for the backseat, they're using PlayStation, and with the PlayStation controller, they want to use their own headphones, which is connected to the controller. Otherwise, can you imagine, there will be six different people playing six different games and all the sounds will be loud and, you know, mixing together.
No.
It will be a big mess.
Yeah.
So it's better not to do it.
Okay.
While playing the game, being in the game and, you know, with their own headphones, or we make a party with the whole system.
Okay.
But that's the thing. So we need amps. I want to have it active.
Okay.
Active. Full active. Full active. And I want to use multiple DSPs, so like one DSP for the interior, one DSP for the back,
exterior.
And then using another DSP only for switching the sources before both of the separate DSPs, you know what I mean?
One DSP central and two DSPs
yes.
for exterior and interior.
Yes, that's right.
Okay, the amps, is, DSP is not a problem. They are small, they can fit.
I know, which amp should
I
we
think,
use?
Yeah, what will fit in the spaces we
yeah, we have. Some space, we have some space behind the seat. That's not really an issue, but...
It looks like I want to.
Behind the wall, no, that one cannot open easily. So we have to remove the back seat. This is the only one which folds forward. But we have some space behind and we can remove all the original equipment. So, but we need power and stability. I think under this seat will go maybe 2 10-inch yeah. in the available space.
Down firing
like we do in several of the cars we did, using 2 10-inch Audison subs, the shallow ones.
Yeah, or if you want the real deep bass, then it's a bass reflex, but then also down firing, because mm-hmm. There's in the double cabin, mm-hmm. you have a square.
Yeah.
And with a square size, you have a lot of dips and peaks. So normally a bus reflex works better.
That would be better
for the deeper.
But still yeah. using 2 10-inch from Audison.
Yeah, it's more than enough.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So I think the smartest thing to do, because inside of the car we are limited by the actual sizes and the dimensions of the internal structure of the car.
Yeah.
So I think I'm very happy. I'm sure I'm very happy now because we know exactly what to do on the inside. On the outside. We know which line to follow, so we will just start constructing the whole frame and whatsoever.
Yep.
And then we will just add as much speakers as possible.
Yeah, first you have the frame, and that's the limitation of the total system.
Yeah, yeah.
And then
so once
you
we have
can
the frame
build
done,
it up.
Once we have the frame done, please come back, and then we can...
Step by step.
Yes,
yeah.
That's the best. But for the internal system of the car, we know now what to do.
Great.
Perfect. All right, so please piss off because I have some work to do. Thank you so much.
Bye bye.
Bye.
Good luck, eh?
Thank you. It's Friday, and as you see, we are quite busy. The Raptor is coming along very well. The soundproofing is already in the doors. It's very, very, very solid. And it's very necessary to have it solid because, as you know, we need a lot of power. It will be playing extremely loud, so we do not want any vibrations or whatsoever. So next week we have to put back everything in the car, because next week we have to bring the car to the what is called RDW, or as they say in Dubai, the RTA. It has to be inspected and checked in order to get the Dutch plates on it. So that will only take 1 or 2 days, then we receive it back and we can continue work on the car. We finalized also the things.
Stop!
Hi Steven, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you very much.
Welcome back.
Yeah, very good, thank you.
Good morning.
That's our chef again. I have a meeting with the client and I want to treat him as we normally treat our guests, with a fantastic lunch. Made by Steven, the one and only.
The one and only.
So, let's continue. Where was I? Yes, we also finalized the plans which gaming PCs we are going to use for this car. And we ordered just everything. This will be very extreme gaming PCs. All the parts should arrive next week, so we can start assembling and do the installation and whatsoever. When that is done, we can finally do the measurements, the amount of power it's going to drain, and then we can calculate the batteries and the chargers and everything. And when we have that fixed, we know all the sizes, then we can finally start with building the construction for the back. So it's all stages. We have to follow the steps exactly in order to make the project work perfectly. This one, the Porsche Macan Turbo, one of our regular clients changed his car. He had a Macan diesel and he changed it now for the turbo. So we of course will do a proper sound installation in this car as well. Don't know when yet exactly. We have a lot of projects going on right now, and this client has several cars, so he does not mind. Actually, I don't think he even drove the car yet. But anyway, it's a nice thing to work on in the loose hours and whatsoever. The 458 Speciale is going the right way. Me and Franklin have constructed the tweeter cups. They are finished, so we have to wrap them with the original Alcantara, which is used on the car. And then next week, since the Raptor is away anyway, I will put back everything in the interior. Put back the amplifier, and then we can start doing the sound checking and whatsoever. So this client can use his car when he wants to, and we finally have our demo ready. So if you want to listen to this car, please let me know, so I can arrange something so you can listen to the car yourself. Then this one, beautiful Porsche 911 GT3, 991 first edition. And we did this car a couple of months ago with a sound system, and unfortunately there was something wrong with the sound. So we collected the car, we checked it out, and there was something inside of the amplifier. I have to be honest with you, that also happens sometimes. It's all electronics what we work with, and yeah, it happens sometimes. So we collected the car from the client, I've inspected it, I've changed the amplifier, I've put back all the settings, and it's ready. It has to be cleaned, and then we will bring it back to the client. So I think our after sales is quite well. As I said, sometimes it happens, but it's the way how we fix it. So he will be happy with the car as well. For now, I have to say, have a very nice weekend. Monday we are closed, it's a national holiday, so on Tuesday we will continue working on all of the projects. So stay tuned. If you like this video, thumbs up, and hopefully I see you back next week. Have a wonderful weekend. Bye-bye.